Hello everyone, welcome back with another interesting video lecture on veterinary parasitology. In this lecture, I'm gonna discuss trichuriasis or Trichuris species or whipworm infection in animals and men. First, I will highlight the causal agents or important species that cause trichuriasis or whipworm infection followed by its morphological features. Then, I will discuss the life cycle, pathogenic significance, and clinical manifestation in animals and men. Finally, I will highlight the diagnosis, treatment, and prevention of trichuriasis or whipworm infection in animals and men. Follow my channel's playlist to get more video lecture on veterinary parasitology. Stay connected with the channel VetMed Lectures to get more video lecture on different subjects of veterinary medicine. So let's get started. Species under the genus Trichuris. There are three genera under the superfamily Trichuridae. They are Trichuris, Trichinella, and Capillaria. Parasites under the genus Trichuris are known as whipworm due to their whip-like appearance, which I am going to discuss in the morphology section. Here, you can see the Trichuris species and their hosts. Trichuris ovis infect various ruminant hosts such as goat, sheep, and cattle. Trichuris switch is important for pigs. Trichuris vulpis commonly infects dogs. Trichuris serrata infects cats. Camel can be infected with different species of Trichuris, such as Trichuris globulosa, Trichuris scargiavini, Trichuris camelli, etc. All these parasites are located in the large intestine, particularly in cecum and colon of the final host. Disease caused by this Trichuris species is known as trichuriasis or whipworm infection. Morphological features of Trichuris species. Adult Trichuris is white and around 3 to 8 cm long. The anterior part of the worm is tapered whip-like, and the posterior part is broad like a handle of a whip. Therefore, the parasite is called whipworm. The female tail is curved and the male tail is coiled. Microscopically, the parasite possesses a mouth stylet and tuberculated bands on the body surface. Esophagus is capillary form in which there is a single layer of cells. Male tail possesses a single spicule in a sheath which is armed with fine cuticular spine. In female worms, the vulva is located wider part of the body. Life cycle of Trichuris species or whipworms. Life cycle is direct as there is no involvement of intermediate host. Final host are different animals that I have already mentioned. The location of this parasite is in the large intestine. Infective stage is L1 containing egg. The female parasite in the large intestine lay eggs which pass with feces or stool. In the environment, L1 developed within eggs by 1 to 2 months under favorable condition. At low temperature, for example, below 20 degrees centigrade, the development of L1 takes a longer time. The infective stage may remain viable for several years. Final hosts are infected by the ingestion of L1 containing eggs through contaminated food and water. Afterwards, eggs hatch in a small intestine and release larval stage 1 or L1. Then L1 penetrate the mucosal layers and mold to L5. Finally, L5 returns to the large intestine and become mature. It is noted that the adult lie on the mucosal surface with their anterior ends embedded in the mucosa. It takes around 4 to 8 weeks to complete the life cycle. Pathogenic significance and clinical manifestation of trichuriasis or whipworm infection in animals. This parasitic infection is important for pig, dog, and man. It causes trichuritis and colitis in heavy infection. I will explain how trichuritis and colitis occur in infected host. You know, adults are embedded in the mucosa by their anterior ends. This tunneling activity in the mucosa damages the tissue and blood vessel, which ultimately provokes inflammation of the large intestine. Further, the mouth stylet that projects through the mouth opening also damages the tissues and blood vessel, resulting in hemorrhagic inflammation of the cecum and colon. Blood loss is further aggravated by the adult worms, as they are blood feeders or blood suckers. Altogether, hemorrhagic trichuritis and colitis are resulted. Clinically, the infection is manifested by watery diarrhea, dehydration, hyperproteinemia, anemia, weight loss, etc. In severe cases, severe diarrhea or dysentery due to secondary bacterial infection along with blood feces is observed. Transmission, pathogenic significance, and symptoms of trichuriasis or whipworm infection in man. Transmission of trichuriasis or whipworm in humans, particularly in small children, occurs due to the eating soil contaminated food and water through the fecal oral route. It is noted that trichuriasis is the third most common soil transmitted roundworm infection in humans. Globally, an estimated 800 million people are infected. The infection is mostly seen in many tropical and subtropical countries of the world. The whipworm infection in man is mostly asymptomatic. Symptomatic infection more commonly occurs in young children in case of heavy infection. It causes catarrhal or hemorrhagic trichuritis and colitis. How does this pathogenic condition happen? I have already discussed. Symptoms include bloody diarrhea, rectal prolapse, abdominal pain, nausea, vomition, weight loss, retardation of growth, etc. Moreover, growth retardation and anemia are characteristic features of TDS or Trichuris dysentery syndrome. Diagnosis of trichuriasis or whipworm infection in animal and man. Diagnosis is based on the clinical signs or findings that I have already discussed. Confirmatory diagnosis includes the examination of feces or stool, flotation techniques using a flotation solution with a specific gravity 1.3 is highly recommended. Upon microscopic examination of feces or stool, reveal characteristics eggs. The eggs are viral or lemon shape, yellow or brown in color, and possess markedly protruded polar plugs. The eggs should be differentiated from the eggs of capillaria species, which is smaller in size, and the polar plugs are not as protruded as seen in trichuris. Complete blood count can also be done for detecting anemia. Treatment of whipworm infection includes administration of different benzimidazole antiemetics such as mebendazole, albendazole, phenbendazole, etc. Administration of macrocyclic lactones such as ivermectins at a regular interval of 3 to 4 months is another effective treatment measure. In kennel dog, it is also recommended to repeat the treatment 3 times at 1 month interval. Proper disposal of feces or stool on a regular basis and maintaining good hygiene is crucial for the control and prevention of trichuriasis or whipworm infection in man and animal. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you have any question, please put it in the comment section below. I'll be happy to answer. And good luck for your study. I'll catch you in the next session.